Hello, artists. Welcome. So glad you're here. Today's art project is based on the theory of warm and cool colors. But before we get to it, let's do a little color review. You've probably seen something that looks like this before. It's a color wheel. And a color wheel is a tool that artists use to understand color. Did you know that a color wheel can be divided in half into warm and cool colors? It can, and that's going to help us with our project today. Warm colors, like red, yellow, orange, or even pink, are those colors that you might associate with the summertime, or things such as fire, the sun, or fall leaves. Cool colors like blue, green, teal, and purple are those colors that you might associate with the wintertime or things such as water, the sky, or ice and snow. Colors can also make us feel a certain way based on their perceived warmth or coolness. So what kinds of feelings do these warm colors give you? Happy? Energized? Excited? What about these cool colors? Cool colors might give you a feeling of calm or relaxation. Colors can have very personal meanings for people too, and that's up to you. In art, warm and cool colors can be used to change our visual perception or how we see and understand something that we're looking at. We can create an illusion of depth or distance away from us by using warm or cool colors. So take a look at these squares. Does one of them feel like it's closer to us than the other? That's an illusion. When we're creating art, you can remember this simple trick. Warm colors, like orange, advance, or they appear to come forward toward us. And cool colors, like the blue, recede, meaning they appear to go backward, away from us. This trick is going to help us with our project today too. So let's get to it. Here are two examples of the art we're creating today using warm and cool colors. On the left, there's a cool color hand with a warm background. And on the right, there's a warm color hand with a cool background. What do you notice? First, the warm and cool colors really pop against each other, don't they? Do you see any illusions? Does the cool color hand look like it's receding? Does the warm color hand look like it's advancing? In this project, you get to choose whether you want a cool hand warm background or a warm hand cool background. In front of you, you should have a piece of paper with some rectangles on it. The first thing we're going to do is flip that piece of paper over, grab a pencil, and write your name and room number on the back of your paper. Once your paper is back right side up, you're going to use your pencil to trace your hand next. Now, where you trace your hand on the paper is up to you. It can be at the bottom, coming from the side or the top, whatever you like. And as you're tracing, please don't worry about erasing and getting it just right. I promise, if it looks anything like a hand, it's perfect. Once you've got a hand on your paper, you're going to trade your pencil for a black Sharpie marker, and you'll retrace your pencil lines using that black marker. Once you have your hand outlined in black, you're ready for color. But before we start coloring, there are some important instructions. First, when we're coloring, we're going to work on the background first. So in your head, decide if you want warm or cool colors for your background. And when it's time, you're going to choose three or four markers that are either warm or cool, not both, and start working on coloring small designs or patterns in the background rectangles. If you need ideas for patterns, you'll find some pinned up on the walls nearby. Now, the markers we're using today are special artist markers, and the best way to use them is with slow, steady strokes, no scribbling. The markers each have two sides. So on one end, there's a broad chisel tip, and that's good for coloring large areas. And on the other side is a bullet tip, which is smaller, and it's good for details. As you color the background, you'll want to be careful to color within the rectangles only. Try to avoid coloring any parts of your hand right now. Once your background is finished, you're going to stop and change your markers because we want to use opposite colors to color our hand. So if you were coloring your background with cool colors, you're going to switch and choose three or four warm colors for your hand. And if you were already coloring with warm colors, you're going to switch and pick three or four cool markers for your hand. To color your hand, you're just going to repeat the process of making small designs or patterns in each area of your hand. And that's it. The rest of this video is just some nice instrumental music to listen to while you explore the world of color and work on your art project. Enjoy, artists! Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.